أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسكم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق أولم يكفي بربك أنه على كل شيء شهيد ويرى الذين أوتوا العلم الذي أنزل إليك من ربك هو الحق ويهدي إلى صراط العزيز الحميد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته viewers today inshallah I'm so very glad I can't hide my sentiment and happiness because in a few days we're going to be entering into the new Islamic calendar the new year of Islam Muharram is right next corner and I'm praying and hopefully that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for us whatever good that comes along in this new year, Ya Allah, we ask you that you make it better for us. And whatever negativity that arises from this new year, Ya Allah, we ask you to remove it from each and every Muslim that is watching this program, inshallah. I'm so excited today. Why am I so excited? Because scientists have delved into a new arena. They have broken another record. They've pushed the envelope. One of the most advancements of science today is the fact that they have come to understand that the earth that we live in today is perpetually moving away from itself, not even the heaven. The heaven is doing the same thing, but they are saying this thing because of new knowledge that have come to them. In 1923, there was a man who lived in Germany by the name Alfred Wegener. He specialized on geophysics. He's one of the best voices that make those kind of statements on how the earth strata move. And he made a very revolutionary statement. What he said was that the continent today, as we see, we call it 7 continents, 6 continents, 5 continents. It used to be one conglomeratic material. They call that stage Pangaea. Pangaea is a Greek word meaning, you know, collectivity of the earth. In other words, it used to be just one. But eventually, for the past 800 million years ago, there was a noise that came and disrupted the earth strata. It broke it into two. So we have you know, Laurasia and Gondwana. Gondwana is the one that brought Africa, Australia, and Antarctica. And then we have Laurasia that deals with part of Asia, excluding India, part of South America and North America and Canada, and the subductional zone of, you know, the world at that time. Well, eventually, again, over 190 million years ago, these two separation again break again. And then 50 million years ago, it break again. And so this is what Alfred Wegener proposed back then in the early 2023, 2024, 2025. But his peers refused to believe in his hypothesis. They say he made an error. Well, at that time, there was a lot of you know, disagreement between the scientists as to whether to believe in him or not. But after he died and passed away, you know, scientists, through pushing the envelope and revolutionizing the concept of in-depth research, they came to understand that what Alfred Wegener said back then was the truth. And the continent today is perpetually moving. They call that the continental drift. Continental drift is the concept that the earth strata is moving away. It's moving, it's moving, it's moving. So every year we have the Atlantic, the Antarctica, the Pacific, and the Indian Ocean. It's actually, you know, moving. It's moving. It's, some say it's like 5 feet every year. Some say 15 feet. Some say 10 feet. But then what they know, what scientists agreed upon is that it is actually moving, you know, away from each other. And that is exactly what scientists have come to record. They call that the continental drift. In other words, the continent is perpetually drifting, but it used to be one Pangaea, one unit together. This is exactly what the Quran have said over 1,400 years ago. Allah said in the Quran, وَتَرَى الْجِبَالِ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ You look at the sky and you think, you look at the earth and you think of it to be a stationary, but it moves just like the clouds also move. There is no way any human being who live in the desert without any technology be able to give us information that is so vital, that is so true, that is so factual, that is so, you know, consistent with modern science. And this is in the Quran. These are some of the things that the Quran does that boggles the mind of science. You have to have technology. You have to be able to go deep into the subductional zone to study the earth, you know, as a whole and to see what dimension does it take. Muhammad have nowhere to do all these things. That's why Allah said, "In huwa illa wahayun yuha adlamahu shadid al-quwa." This Quran is no less than a revelation sent upon you, Muhammad, from Lawh al-Mahfuz. Adlamahu Shadid al Quwa. You are taught by one who is mighty in power. And so, really, I'm so excited. I don't know what to say. I sent this verse in the Quranic wording to one of my, you know, scientist friend, and for him to observe and give me, you know, an analysis as to what I've said based upon science and the Quran. And he just came and he laughed at me. He said, "Muhammad, you and your science." And that is the truth. These are scientists. Allah said, وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَيَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. Those who have the knowledge of Muhammad, they will come eventually and they will prove exactly that what Allah, what you are saying is the truth, and that you came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is one of the miracles of Quran, one among thousands of miracles in the Quran. Just so you understand, science is not proving the Quran right. Quran does not need anyone to prove it right. Science is a self-repairing enterprise. Between now and then, it discards most theory and allow new ones to come in. And that is how science progressed. But the Quran knowledge came from Lawhil Mahfuz, the preserved tablet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is something to celebrate the glory of the Quran. Men of knowledge are actually proving it, but they could prove it all they want. The Quran is there. It's sort of like a yardstick for measuring where the fact actually is. And so we are so very happy as we usher ourselves into the next millennium of Islamic New Year, Muharram. We are trying to let the world understand the Quran is indeed a book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that no human being would be able to write a book like the Quran. The challenge has been there for quite a long time, and no human being born yet have come close to making that challenge. Khazabillahi tawfiq. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.